الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، أرسله الله بدين الهدى ونور الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون ولو كره المشركون. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. My dear brothers today and sisters, today inshallah we are going to actually talk about something. It's one subject but has like two approaches. We would like to talk about something we are all looking forward to be rewarded with. Of course, we are on the third, on the last one-third of the month. Today is actually one of the odd nights, the 25th night, which can be Laylatul Qadr. And of course, we all would love to be rewarded with Jannah. Jannah can be translated as heaven or paradise. And today we are going to try to speak a little bit about the description of Jannah, and then we will move right away on the description of the people who deserve Jannah, or Ahlul Jannah, the people of heaven or the people of paradise. Here actually, when we are talking about the very simple, description for Jannah is فيها ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على بال أحد. So, Jannah is something you cannot even imagine, you cannot even think of. And here actually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم مثل الجنة التي وعد المتقون تجري من تحتها الأنهار أكلها دائم وظلها. He is describing the Jannah, which was promised to the muttaqin, al-muttaqun, okay, the people who have great deal of piety and sincerity and a humbled al-muttaqun, great faith. مثل الجنة التي وعد المتقون تجري من تحتها الأنهار أكلها دائم وظلها. You will never be hungry in it and you will never feel hot or warm. Another verse, مثل الجنة التي وعد المتقون فيها أنهار من غير من ماء غير آسن وأنهار من لبن لم يتغير طعمه وأنهار من خمر لذة للشاربين وأنهار من عسل مصفى ولهم فيها من كل الثمرات ومغفرة من ربه. Another description, one description saying that it is built over rivers actually, and here actually in another description it has a lot of rivers from different type of liquids. The first one, which is a good water, is never spoiled. وأنهار من لبن, milk, لم يتغير طعمه. وأنهار من خمر لذة للشاربين. وأنهار من عسل مصفى. It is all something related to what actually a good nutrients for the human body, and this is just for us to realize how great is such a place to be in after the hereafter, or after the day of judgment. وَلَهُمْ فِيهَا مِنْ كُلِّ الثَّمَرَاتِ all the fruits وَمَغْفِرَةٌ مِنْ رَبِّهُمْ of course, above all, the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another description, وَبَشِّرِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ أَنَّ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتِ gave the glad tidings to those people الذين آمنوا, who believed وعملوا الصالحات, and they actually, their action is agreeing with what they believed in. وعملوا الصالحات, أن لهم جنات, they will be rewarded with a paradise, تجري من تحتها الأنهار, كلما رزقوا منها من ثمرة رزقا قالوا هذا الذي رزقنا من قبل وأتوا به متشابها ولهم فيها أزواج مطهرة وهم فيها خالدون. Of course, when you know, when you see fruits in heaven or in paradise, and you think that this is the same like the one you have or you had before in dunya, you know, أتوا به متشابها ولهم فيها أزواج مطهرة, and they have the most purified wives, أزواج مطهرة, ولهم فيها أزواج مطهرة, وهم فيها خالدون, and this is the eternal life which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised us. In another verse, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. سَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ, compete, you know, for a forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in addition to the forgiveness, compete means do a good deed, do a, you know, give charity, fast, pray, and you know, be nice to others or treat others well. وَسَارِعُوا, this is the how you compete. You do things, actually, then you will deserve the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ, the forgiveness from Allah. Allah is the only one who forgives. وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٌ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضُ, is talking about how wide this heaven or paradise, عِدَّةٌ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ, it is prepared just for those who have a good faith. And then he started describing those al-muttaqin, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالدَّرَّاءِ, those who give from their money, وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظِ, those who hold their anger, وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ, those who forgive others, وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ, Allah always loves those who actually do good, or do good to people, وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم, if they did sin or they, you know, they sinned, أو ظلموا أنفسهم, or they did themselves wrong, ذكروا الله, they remembered Allah, they returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they remembered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فاستغفروا لذنوبهم, and they ask for forgiveness. والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم, ذكروا الله, فاستغفروا لذنوبهم, وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الدُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, and who will forgive, you know, our sins except Allah subhanahu, وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ, and they did not insist or persist on sinning, وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ, and they know that this is not right. So we started with the description of how, you know, the Jannah is beautified for the believer, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala order the angels to prepare the Jannah for those who have good faith, al-muttaqin. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed us who are those al-muttaqin. So, فِيهَا مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ وَلَا خَطَرَ عَلَى بَالِ أَحَدٍ. And then actually here, this is the Quran from the Hadith. عن أبي مالك الأشعري رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن في الجنة غرفا يرى ظاهرها من باطنها وباطنها من ظاهرها أعدها الله لمن أطعم الطعام وأدام الصيام وصلى بالليل والناس نيام أخرجه الطبراني. This is talking about where you are going to be actually. It is something cannot be imagined how يعني you are يعني staying in rooms where you can see يرى ظاهرها من باطنها, you can see in and out, and then actually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, who is this, you know, the rooms is prepared for? At'am at-tu'am, those that will feed the needy. Adam as-siyam, he yani continued fasting. And sallallahu bil-layli wa nasiyam. And then actually, this is the hadith by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa sallallahu bil-layli wa nasiyam. That means he is making, you know, salat, you know, during the night. This is not a salat al-mafruḍa. And there is another hadith here. عن أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إذا دخل أهل الجنة الجنة ينادي مناد. When the people of Jannah will be in Jannah, when they enter a paradise, there somebody is going to call. إن لكم أن تصحوا فلا تسقموا. تصحوا فلا تسقموا. There is no sickness whatsoever. تصحوا فلا تسقموا أبدا. وإن لكم أن تحيوا فلا تموتوا. You are going to be, you're going to have eternal life. تحيوا فلا تموتوا أبدا. وإن لكم أن تشبوا فلا تهرموا. You are not going to get old. Never. وإن لكم أن تنعموا فلا تبأسوا. You are going to be enjoying all the blessing and the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you will never feel any misery. And then actually the hadith is continued with قول الله عز وجل ونودوا أن تلكم الجنة أورثتموها بما كنتم تعملون. This is the Jannah which you inherited for what you have been, what you have done. And another hadith, hadith Qudsi, قال الله عز وجل أعددت لعبادي الصالحين ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر. We just mentioned that. Okay. And here actually على قلب بشر. And then the verse فلا تعلم نفس ما أخفي لهم من قرة أعين جزاء بما كانوا يعملون. The bottom line is that in heaven there is no misery whatsoever, there is no sickness whatsoever, there is no getting older. You are going to be always in a certain age, and you are going to be the most happiest, you know, person. There is no sadness, there is no grief, and of course Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is rewarding all of us for what we are doing. And of course we ask Allah's forgiveness, and we would love to be rewarded by the Jannah. Yes, we are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His sake. We are worshipping Allah for His sake. But we actually hoping that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward us by Jannah, where we will be happy forever and all the time. Now, for you to be actually, to deserve to be from Ahlul Jannah, here actually the first description of Ahlul Jannah. We mentioned U'iddat lil-muttaqeen, al-muttaqeen. وهم الذين اتقوا ربهم باتخاذ الوقاية من عذابه بفعل ما أمرهم به من طاعة له ورجاء لثوابه وترك ما نهاهم عنه طاعة له وخوفا من عقابه. This is the description of المتقين. Those actually who followed every order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they always fear Him publicly and secretly, سرًا وعلانية, and they obeyed Him in every aspect of their worshipping. And they tried to protect themselves from His torment, punishment, by being a good, obedient believer, and take what He gave and leave what he prohibited us from doing. And of course, in another description, also it can be الذين أمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر, those actually who enjoying the good and forbid the bad. So the first category of أصحاب الجنة المتقين. Then actually the second category is الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء. Of course, later on we are going to see the description of a believer according, you know, different places in the Quran. But here actually right away, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ, here actually is, يعني, الصدقة is one of the highest level of worshipping. Especially when you give from something, the very closest and things the Son of Adam likes very well is his wealth. You know, we all attach to our wealth. We don't want to lose it. We don't want to give. وَلِعَزُ بِاللَّهِ, this is actually the greedy one. But here, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ, they always spend from their own money, both in good time and hard one. الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ, فَهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ مَا أُمِرُوا بِإِنْفَاقِهِ عَلَى الْوَجْهِ الْمَطْلُوبِ مِنْهِمْ مِنَ الصَّدَقَاتِ والزكاة والنفقات على من له حق عليهم والنفقات في الجهاد. This is the different categories of how you can spend, you know, or how you give from your money. الذين ينفقون, those who spend. And we mentioned that this is zakat, which is obligatory, الصدقات, which is voluntarily, which is a higher grade, because actually because, you know, if you don't do the obligatory thing, you're going to be punished. But the voluntarily, you're not going to be rewarded. So we would like to be rewarded, and we do more voluntarily things, actually, in addition to the, you know, the obligatory one. الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. So we said الْمُتَّقِينَ, or الْمُتَّقُونَ, those who had the highest level of piety and good faith, and as close as they can be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. Right after that, something related to a very, very hard behavior, الْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظِ. When you control your anger, القاذمين الغيظ. Of course, this is number three. If you can hold your anger to the extent that you don't hurt anyone, this is great characteristic, and you will be rewarded, and you will be from Ashab al-Jannah. Now, when you hold your anger, then what's the next one? والعافين عن الناس. You forgive. And whenever I talked about the forgiveness between people, I always say this is the hardest thing had to be done, especially if you are hurt badly from somebody and you feel like you did everything to make peace between them, but still they hurt you. How can I forgive them? Well, you have to, you know, overcome. You have to overcome the ego from within you, and you forgive them. Not because of them, because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I always say, forgive. But you may not forget. So we said, المتقين, we said, الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاظمين الغيظ, they hold their anger. وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ, they forgive people no matter what. Then inshallah, in the next khatra, we'll continue with the rest of the description of Ashab al-Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all between those who are Ashab al-Jannah and who are where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are pleased with them. من الذين رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه. من الذين رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه. Those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are pleased with them and they are pleased or pleased Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and are pleased with him inshaAllah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our deed, our fasting, our prayer, our dua inshaAllah and answer everyone's حاجة إن شاء الله. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين وصلي اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.